Hello, this is my YouTube homework 6. Question 1 part A. For two grinders will receive the same input and will have the same change in momentum but with the opposite direction. So the grinder A, when the grinder A hit the grinder B and then moving back, so it moves to the left and the grinder B will continue move to the right. So for the system C, I have the net force up the earth on the grinder C and the gravity force down for the system C on the earth, and I have the force I think here I'm doing incorrect. This one should be shorter than this one, and the force is from the grinder B on the system C, and this one should be longer. The force from the grinder A on the system C. This is should be C. Next question: the grinder A is the smaller mass, so it has the greater change for the velocity. And I will show you more for the next question. Here. Because P, the direction of change in velocity, grinder A is to the left and the grinder B is to the right. This is my equation, and I get the velocity for A, the final velocity for A is bigger than the final of velocity for the B. So the velocity of grinder B is slower than the grinder A. And also, I have the same relation for next question. The magnitude of the change is in the velocity vector for the grinder A is greater than the magnitude of change in the velocity vector for the grinder B. Part C. My statement will be the grinder A will move faster than the grinder B because the change in momentum of grinder A is greater. Next question. Question 2 part A, the first question. My answer is no because the motion of the left piece was changed and it has expulsion of the force on it. This should be the expulsion, but I write it wrong. And next question, I will say yes because there is no external influence for it, so the net force on the system is zero. Question 3. The momentum of the left piece is not converse because it stays at rest and then moving. And for the next question, I will say yes because the momentum are equal magnitude but opposite direction, so the velocity is zero. No, the vector is zero. I'm sorry. Part B. Question 1. The net force on the blocks is not always zero because the blocks sliding down in the incline and has acceleration on the gravity on it. Question 2. The net force on the incline is always zero because the incline is at rest and not moving. Question 3. The net force on the block and incline system always zero. Use Newton's third law, and when the block is not moving, they have a zero net force. The momentum of the block is not converse because the block is acceleration on the incline. So the inclines, so the kinetic friction is increased and the velocity is changed. The momentum of the incline is conserved because the velocity is not changed. The momentum of the block and incline system is not conserved because the system has a velocity, so the momentum is not conserved. The net force on the block is not always zero because there is a net force on the block when it's slide down on the incline, so it has the acceleration on it. The net force on the incline is not always zero because the incline is at it has the acceleration and moving. Question 3. The net force on the block and the incline system is not zero because the blocks and inclines is moving because the table is frictionless. Next question. The momentum of the blocks is not conserved because the block is acceleration down on the incline. Number 5. The momentum of the incline is also not conserved because the incline is acceleration on the table. Number 6. The momentum of the table and the incline system is conserved because there is no external force on the system. Part D. First question. The net force on the blocks is not zero because they are moving, so the net force is not zero. The net force on the system S is not zero too because there is a gravity force on the system. The momentum of the block A is not conserved because there is external force acting on them. The momentum of systems S is not conserved too because there is external force acting on the system S. Question 3, part A. I list my equation here and then I will easy to draw the picture because the grader A is moving to the grader B, so the vector is going to the left and the grader B is the velocity is zero, so it doesn't move, but the system will be moved because the momentum of the system is equal to the momentum A plus the momentum B. They are equal to the mass times velocity. And next question. The velocity vector for the grader A is zero, so it doesn't move. But for the grader B, it moves to the left. Because it's negative. And you can see from my equation. Next question, part C. The momentum vector for the grader A and the grader B are also goes to the left because the momentum for the grader A is equal to the negative 4m times velocity. And the momentum of grader B is equal to the negative 5 mass times the velocity. I made a mistake for speaking this one. This is the momentum of the grader A and the grader X, and this is the momentum of grader B and the grader X. Next question, part D. The momentum of the grader A and the grader X is equal to the momentum of grader A divided by the momentum of grader X. So I have, my answer is negative 4 mass times velocity. So it moved to the left. So this statement is correct. Next question. If the mass is different, they will have different magnitude. Thank you for listening. Good night.